Maybe you should leave it on longer. He might just need another second or two.
Miss Hamley, you can bring Matt into the office now. Your father and I will meet you there.
That's it, huh?
I've seen enough to determine a conclusive result.
After a couple of flashing lights and a teddy bear, you're going to tell me my grandson is deaf and dumb?
No. After a couple of flashing lights and a teddy bear, I'm going to tell you you have a highly intelligent grandson who's profoundly deaf. Interacting with other deaf children will really help. You should consider sending him to a residential school and having him learn sign language. I know it's difficult.
Matt's not going to some deaf school. He's going to Loveland Elementary, just like his brother. Let's go, Janet.
Dad, I want to know what our options are.
I know this seems overwhelming, but millions of people have gone through this. You're not alone.
Time for recess. Recess, we're lining up.
Thank you. Dad?
Yeah?
I've been, reconsidering the residential school idea for Matt. Or at least some sign language classes.
He's fine. Okay, boys. Pat, you drive for a minute.
Okay. Hey, big boy.
Water. 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 That's good. Yes. Water. 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 Good boy. Good boy. There we go. He's a great kid, Mike, but since the divorce, things have been tough. I know he could be a good wrestler.
Hey, you need something, buddy?
Nah, he's fine. We've just been working on his speech.
Really? Look, Stan, I don't think this is gonna work out. I mean, it's tough enough with the kids I have, you know? How's the fam holding up? How's Janet doing?
What are you asking, Mike?
I was just wondering.
If she's available?
Well, is she?
Coach. 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 Good. I'll tell Janet you said hello.
Everybody hustles out there, okay, guys? Nobody quits. Let's pair up by weight. Let's go. Come on, guys. Martin, I want you to wrestle Matt. Okay, guys. Now listen, keep your spacing. I want to see single leg takedowns. On my whistle, guys. Martin.
Take it easy on him, okay?
All right. Let's do this again.
Stanley, what have you gotten me into?
Let's try this one more time, okay? And that's where you pin him.
Let's go. You see that?
All right, guys, great practice. Shower up. Great job, guys. Good job. Nice job. Good job.
job.
All right, Matt, Dale, enough.
Good job, guys. 6 o'clock tomorrow, okay?
Matt, great job out there. Great technique on those arm throws.
Thanks, coach.
You need a ride?
No man should have taken me.
Have you heard from Purdue yet?
Not yet.
Hey, tell your mom, Friday night, my turn to cook dinner, okay?
Okay.
All right, great job.
So what are you doing today? What are you doing today?
I've got another acting practice to go to. My brother taking me.
Oh, Pat?
Now his other brother, genius.
Shut up.
Maybe we should all go on a double date.
Yeah, okay. How about you abort the conversation, Viv?
How about you tell someone that he smells like B.O.?
All right. Well, here we are, sir.
What? It's not like he can hear us anyway.
Oh, Matt. I don't know if that's such a great idea.
Why?
Well, I don't know. I mean, our families have been friends for years. Wouldn't that be kind of weird? You can't dance, right? I mean, you can't hear the music.
No, but I can feel the vibration. Did you know?
No.
See?
Look. I'm sorry. Do you still need a ride tomorrow? Sorry.
Bye, Matt.
No.
Where are those boys? I swear, if they don't quit missing dinners, I'm gonna quit making them.
Matt's picking up some extra practice over Kenston. Pat gave him a ride. I wanted to wait till Matt got home, but take a look.
A full ride to Purdue? Is this right? Oh my God.
It's one of the best wrestling programs in the nation.
Oh my God. What's this?
It's RIT. Another acceptance. But the other one's the one we really care about.
Well, I think that we should still consider both options. There's a great deaf school at RIT, and he'll really get the support he needs. I'm just worried he'll get lost at Purdue.
We don't need a deaf program. Do you even realize how good of a wrestler your son is? He has so much more potential than you give him credit for. He could be a national champion.
Well, why don't we let Matt make his own decisions? Hey!
Come on.
You hungry?
No, I can't. I have to cut weight.
I'll eat his dinner.
Pat, you don't have to gain weight for him to lose it. In the meantime, I want you to read this letter.
Scholarship?
There's another letter for you.
Rochester? She's a backup.
Well, I guess that makes up for the prom rejection, right?
You invited somebody to the prom?
Go study now.
What?
Get in.
Pretty exciting news that came yesterday.
Yeah.
You giving it any more thought?
It's there to think about. I'm going to Purdue, don't you think?
You know what I think? Why limit yourself when you can compete with the best?
That's not what Mom thinks.
Your mother has your best interest at heart. Always. I want you to remember that. In fact, she's dying to know what happened with Michelle.
It's not that of a big deal.
Prom only happens once. Anything that only happens once is a big deal.
I don't think she likes me.
Well, if you don't believe in yourself, I'm not going to. Now get out of here.
Doing? What time is it?
6:15.
Shh. I mean, you just decided to run over here and ask me to pardon?
Yes.
You have no idea how loud you're being, do you?
No. So will you go with me?
Why don't you just ask me properly at school?
Okay. So you think you'll say yes?
Yes. Yes, I will, okay? Just go, okay? I'll see you at school.
These might be a little bit snug, but they'll do the trick, all right? So, what do you have planned after prom?
Early practice for the one I'm missing tonight.
There's more to life than wrestling with dudes. Women like to wrestle too. Oh, Matt! 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 Matt!
How'd I look?
Perfect. Yeah.
She's gonna be fine.
Hi, Mrs. Russell. Hi, Michelle.
Hi. Cool car.
Look real pretty.
Thanks. Cool tux. Yeah. Yeah, I got it. Thanks. Thank you. It's beautiful. Let's get out of here before my mom makes my dad drive us.
Want me to order for you?
Fine.
What?
It said that's fine.
Hello? Can I get 2 number 3s, please? I always get 3.
What kind of drinks would you like with that, sir?
He wants to know what you want to drink.
2 cokes, please.
Come on, hurry the hell up already.
Which one?
Hello, any day now.
Michelle, I'll wait for you in the hallway. Please talk one more.
I just wanted to let you know that Michelle's mom came to pick her up. She wasn't feeling well, and she wanted to tell you herself. I'm sorry, Matt. Thank you.
prime equals d squared y over dx squared. Function y equals fx, where x and y are naturally scaled orthogonal coordinates. Excuse me? Excuse me? Excuse me?
Your interpreter's up here for you.
Just come on. Okay, now, the astringent curvature, K, of a plane curve at a given point on the curve is defined as the derivative of the tangent angle with respect to the position on the curve at that point.
Excuse me, Professor.
What did you just say?
I can't these live.
Shuffles. Hamill. Hamill. You're late. Let's go. Shots. Man, it's the first day of practice. Come on. Gentlemen, we're going to partner up. 2 minute live goes. Hamill, once you're working with Miller, everybody else, grab your training partners, get a spot on the mat. Get moving. Come on. We're going on my whistle, guys. Let's go. Stay focused, Hamill. Miller, back up. Let's get up, guys. Let's go. Back up. Miller pins Hamill again.
Where's your head at, son?
Thanks for coming in.
No problem, Coop.
Here's the thing. I understand that your handicap is something.
I'm not handicapped.
Your record's 6-8, Matt.
I know that, sir, but I've been working really hard.
In your GPA, it's below the minimum required for the scholarship.
I can get it up.
I'm sorry. This wasn't an easy decision.
I came here to win a national championship, sir. And no one can do it.
This is the Big Ten. Don't take it personally.
Matt. Hey, back in good old Loveland, huh?
Good to see you. So, my truck. Every time I pull up to a stop sign, she stalls out. I don't know what's wrong with her. Strange.
Hi, Matt.
You remember my wife, Michelle, right? So, when should I call about the truck?
Tomorrow afternoon.
All right. We'll call you tomorrow.
Honey, I'll be out in just a second, okay? So, shouldn't you be up for due?
Not anymore. Michelle, I want to apologize for reading your prom.
Nah, don't be silly.
No, this is something I think about. I wish I can do it over.
Well, I think we all know how that feels. You still love tacos?
Congratulations. You'll be a great mother.
Thank you. It's funny how things turn out, huh? Never pictured you as a mechanic. Not that there's anything wrong with that, it's just... I always saw you somewhere else doing something different. Thought for sure you'd make it out of here. Anyway, I should get going. It was good to see you, Matt.
Well, Matt, who was that, girlfriend?
In the oven, buddy.
What's the matter with you, huh? Why do you think you have the right to feel sorry for yourself?
Don't pretend you understand what it's like to be me. You always have, but you have no idea.
You're looking for a pity party?
Failed at Purdue.
So what?
I went there for you.
Hey, I never lied to you, boy. I told you your whole life that you don't need to be treated different.
But I am different.
That doesn't mean you're any worse off than anyone else. The world can be cruel, no matter who you are. No one is exempt from that. But if you still want a chance at an education and a national championship, then you're gonna have to stop feeling sorry for yourself, roll up your sleeves, and get back to work. Your mom convinced me, and we've done some rearranging. We're gonna send you to RIT this fall.
No going anywhere.
We're gonna refinance the house to pay for the first year. RIT said they'd consider a scholarship after that.
I don't want your money.
Get in the truck.
I'll be back in a minute. Roll out the mat.
What are you laughing at?
What are you doing?
Oh, so you don't think I can take you, huh?
Grandpa, don't be ridiculous.
Boy, I don't want any excuses. You worry about yourself.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. You see how much you gotta learn?
I'm gonna write you up.
Yeah.
No, thanks. I will stay and I'll pack. 167. Maybe I should move up to 190. Sorry, I have not been around many deaf people. I was the only deaf person in my town. I'm only here for one thing. National championship. One thing.
Ladies, we've been practicing now for 1 month to see who's got what it takes to become or remain part of this team.
He gives the same speech every year.
Nick, give me 50. Today, we decide who our starters will be for each weight class. Lose today, lose your spot. And I don't care if you're a senior. I don't care if you're Randy Macho Man Savage, you understand? You understand?
Yes, coach.
No excuses. Coach, who's up first? Coach!
190.
190's on the mat, let's go. Come on, pick it up. Shake hands. Russell.
Sevens.
Let's go. Where's that? All right, last chance for 167s.
Reserve.
Looks like someone wants a shot at the team captain. Hey.
Zero. You're up, you're down.
Russell! Reversal, 2.
Looks like we got ourselves a new wrestler, Coach.
We'll see.
Does it matter? It's just what I do to get focused. I think I'm going to take off. Everyone, I think you have me confused with someone else. So, we hear you used to be lingerie model. Thank you. Oh, really? That's cool. Sorry, I said that's cool.
Hammer! You're the man. Man.
Thanks. To learn more about the Tenet thing.
Do they know this is wrestling? Why are there so many people here?
We're here for the hammer, Coach.
The hammer?
Yeah. Hammer.
Oh, boy.
That was easy.
Someone tell the hammer to get on the mat. Coach! Let's go, Matt.
Gone for now, just leave quietly.
about it. It's not a big deal.
Thank you. too.
Set up, finish your takedowns. Let's go.
Hey, look at that group over there, Seth, man. I'm gonna talk to him for a sec. Hey. You're White Beach, right?
I ran out of time.
No. You had a strategy, scoring points.
Yeah, but time ran out before.
Pin him? You don't have to pin everyone you wrestle. The goal is to win, right? Takedown, reversal, 2 points, escape, 1 point.
Near fall, 2 or 3 points.
Coach, I know what these. It doesn't matter. I know I can pin him.
Even the best wrestlers, they can't pin quality opponents most of the time. Look, you don't have to pin. You just have to win.
Hey.
What's your point? breathe easy, treat the doing this for you. English is my first language. To understand why you wanted to change me. What happened?
Show Matt what you learned.
Pat, we should go. Come on.
Okay, Paul.
One last week. 10-0.
Not yet. No champions until next week. Satan? Join them. love you too, Grandpa. I don't need anyone's help.
Christy!
Where is he? Where is he? There he is! Look who decided to show back up! Look who decided!
I can't understand you!
Cantrell! Where the hell is Cantrell? Tell this little piss Anthony if he has the nerve to disappear, not return our phone calls, and cha-cha-cha back here like nothing happened!
Coach, his grandfather just died. I just hurt myself.
Grandfather.
Matt, the school and the athletic department has very stern rules. One of which is, if you miss more than 3 consecutive practices, then you're unable to participate in the following match.
Coach, it's the Nationals!
Exactly, which is why I had to spend the entire week covering for you with the athletic director. You should have called, you know, kept us in the loop. You might think the world revolves around you, Matt, but what you don't understand is that wrestling's also a team sport. Fix this chalkboard, Gettrell. Meet me in my office.
I guess nothing goes just how you plan, but it made me strong, made me a man. When I'm looking back someday, I won't have one complaint. Took life as it came. Made some pretty good lemonade.
No, sorry. Wow, she was pretty upset when we left. Oh yeah, sure, of course. Put them on her desk. We're rooting for you.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 1997 Division III NCAA Wrestling Championship. We've got a great crowd here today at RIT. Walter Kowalski of RAC loses by disqualification.
Are you crazy?
Coach, that was his fourth violation.
Hey, genius, he's deaf. Maybe didn't hear you, huh?
Coach, here's your warning. Unsportsmanlike conduct.
Give me a break.
For each weight class.
So, here we are. Seems certainly fitting that this is how it's coming to a close. Jason Sloan, two-time national champ, gets Matt Hamill. Whoever wins tonight will forever be called a champion. Sloan, well, he's looking to be called a three-time national champion. That's what's at stake for him. That's how bad he wants it. And the only thing standing in the way of everything this guy has ever worked for is a sophomore walk-on. So what's at stake for Mr. Hamill? Winning a national championship. No doubt. That's not really it, is it? When you guys go back to that gymnasium, I want you to look in the stands. I want you to look in the crowd. Because those are the stakes. If your hand's raised at the end of the match, not only will you be called a champion, but I guarantee you'll have inspired thousands of others to do the same. All right? All right, let's bring it in, guys. Come on.
Matt Hamill, sophomore walk-on out of RIT, is set to take on Jason Sloan, two-time national champion out of Frampton, for the 167-pound national title.
Hamill, you got this. Up to you now. Good luck.
Season here, but hasn't come close to facing a wrestler with Sloan's ability and consistency. Regardless, they both look ready to go, and this should prove to be an exciting matchup. And we're underway. The wrestlers seem to be feeling each other out here. Hamill keeping some good wrist control. Wrestlers are really on top of their game here.
Oh, Sloan tries a shot there, but Hamill's not having it.
Two, take down, wait.
2-0 Sloan. Now he's throwing in his legs, probably going to try his power half. And out of time.
Back to the middle, guys.
Well, Hamill got lucky there. He didn't give up any back points.
Let's go! Come on!
So now we're going into the second period with Sloan at 2, Hamill 0, and here's the coin toss.
Green, your choice. Top, bottom, neutral, or defer. Green defers, red. Top, bottom, or neutral. Red takes down.
Take it to the bottom. Let's go, Matt. Take it to the bottom. Let's go, Matt.
Here we go. Hamill obviously trying for an escape or a reversal. He's up.
Come on!
And out of bounds, no points.
Back to the middle. Red still down. Top man, huh?
Okay, they're resetting. Sloan still in top position.
Come on, Matt.
Hot Sloan still dominating. Hamill on the ground. Gets him in his back. Hamill gets back to his base, but he gives up 2 back points. Hamill with a grabby roll out of nowhere. Back is Hamill on the board with 1 escape point.
Come on.
Hamill still trails by 3 as this period is coming to an end.
10 seconds. Bottom.
And here we go, the third and final period. Let's Sloan up. Another point for Sloan.
One green escape. One green.
That puts Hamill down four. All right, he's going to have to pull out all the stops here in the final minutes.
Red, three red.
Yes!
Unbelievable. He pulled it off. He got the takedown. He got the near fall. And Matt Hamill wins by decision 6-5. Matt the Hammer Hamill has dethroned Jason Sloan. Matt Hamill, your 167-pound national champion.
Oh, I love you. I love you. I love you.
close my eyes, I see ahead. What I held inside until I bled. But mama don't feel bad because I bleed. You already gave me all I need.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC light heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, a freestyle fighter holding a professional record of 9 wins, 2 losses. Standing 6'1" tall, weighing in at 205 pounds, fighting out of Utica, New York by way of Loveland, Ohio, Matt the Hammer Hamill.
Oh, you water, girl, to my soul. I'm water, girl, I lose control. I'm water, ma, I'll break through that wall. I'm water, ma, I run, I fall. Oh, you know, I got so much on my mind, but my heart runs on its own time. It's a lonely walk through a crowd so unkind, but in the dark is where the stars realign. That wall, I'm water, ma, I run, I fall.